Now it's happening again in the only place in America that is more synonymous with sun than the state of Arizona is.
Have you tried chilled orange juice from Florida? It comes in a handy carton like this, squeezed, chilled, and ready to serve. Now you can buy it at your food store or have it delivered at your door. And it's got everything, too. Vitamin C, quick energy, wonderful flavor, and it's packed with that Florida sunshine.
Packed with that Florida sunshine. Florida is, technically speaking, the Sunshine State. That's their official state nickname, and they do not mean it as a metaphor. They mean that as a founding principle, right? A main attraction of what Florida is. The Florida Department of Citrus has a new branded Avengers character called Captain Citrus. Captain Citrus runs on solar power. The circles on his hands are solar pods. Maybe it's my solar pods, but you're going down. Florida is so much the Sunshine State that the whole ad campaign for the city of Fort Lauderdale is called Find Your Sunny. And you can find Fort Lauderdale at sunny.org. Explore your sunny side in Florida, the Sunshine State. And so now, naturally, because it's Florida, Florida has declared war on the sun, even as it still wants to be known as the Sunshine State. This past week, very quietly, just before Thanksgiving, Florida, incredibly, decided to try to kill solar power in the state of Florida. They voted to kill entirely the rebate program in the state for installing solar panels. At the same time, they told Florida power companies that they basically should stop their efforts to conserve energy. Duke Energy had pledged that by 5 years from now, they would come up with a way to conserve 333 gigawatt hours of energy. Florida, just before Thanksgiving, just last week, decided to cut that from 333 to 21. Tampa Electric, by comparison, they'd pledged to save almost nothing over the next 5 years. Now Florida says they have to save less than half of nothing. Look at the powers, look at the numbers from Florida Power and Light. Florida Power and Light was going to find a way to save 229 gigawatt hours of energy. That's what they'd pledged. Now Florida says, don't sweat it. They dropped that goal from 229 hours to 4 hours. And they killed the program for solar power in the Sunshine State. Power companies, utilities, right, they make money by selling power. The more power you use, the more they can sell you. And therefore, the more money they make. If you make the power yourself from the sun, the solar panels on your roof, right? Or if you or they or anybody finds a way to use less power, then they're selling less power and they make less money. And so Florida, right now, at the request of the utility companies, right before Thanksgiving, very quietly, just decided to stop conserving energy as a state policy. They're no longer even going to try to do that. And they've decided to unplug from the sun. In the Sunshine State. It's amazing. It's interesting here in the politics. One of the groups that protested against these changes in Florida, before Florida made these changes last week, was a group called the Green Tea Coalition. Yes, they are in fact a Tea Party group that is super right-wing like the rest of the Tea Party, but they like the idea of people making their own electricity and people having choices on how to make their own electricity. Getting rid of solar power, even fining people for using the sun, trying to make everybody use fossil fuel power from power plants and as much of it as possible. This is a thing now in Republican politics. It's not getting a lot of attention. It's not getting any beltway attention. But they have just done this in Arizona this past year. They are gearing up to try again to do it in Kansas. And now they have done it in the biggest state yet. Now they have done it in Florida. In the Sunshine State, they have decided they are against the sun. I don't know what Captain Citrus's politics are, but I think there's a pretty good chance he's going to be mad about this when he finds out what Florida just did, when that very, very quiet news starts to get out.